my name is Bobby Marty. I'm a registered dietitian at Mercy Medical Center in Cedar Rapids.
And I'm Andy Deitmeyer, chef for Mercy Medical Center in Cedar Rapids. And today we're going to be preparing a roasted red pepper and fresh herb vinaigrette. What you're going to really like about this, it's a very versatile type of vinaigrette. You can use it as a salad dressing, you can use it as a plate sauce, a marinade. Extremely versatile and very simple to make.
And as far as nutritional benefits, obviously there's lots of, as Andy shows you, he's going to see, show you the different ingredients. It's mostly full of different vegetables in here, and we all know that we need lots of vegetables every day. Aim for 5 to get enough antioxidants and phytochemicals. And specifically in the red pepper, full of vitamin C, fiber.
Well, to get started, first thing we want to do is roast our pepper. Roasting a pepper is a very simple process. It really alters the flavor of the pepper. We can do this one of two ways. You can either do it on your grill on a high heat. What you want to do is just rub a little bit of oil on the pepper. This will help the skin separate when it roasts. And today we're going to do it on the grill, but you could also do it in your oven. High heat, about 425 degrees. And that would take, it'll take about 10 minutes either way, whether it's on the grill or in your oven. And you want to let that roast until you start to see the outside of the pepper start to char. And when you do it on the grill, you'll start to see it char black, like it's almost looking like it's burnt. That's okay, we want that. In the oven, it'll just, you'll see it'll start to, the skin will start to blister, and you know you're about done. So we got our grill hot, about 450, 500 degrees. You want it real nice and hot, so you get that nice char and that searing of the outside of the pepper. I'm just gonna throw that on there. And just turn it periodically to have it so it cooks evenly. And we'll come back and check on that in a few minutes. Okay, so I just pulled our pepper off the grill. This is what we're looking for. The skin is really nice and starting to blister. We got a little char on there. That's great. We want all of that because that's all going to impart a lot of flavor into what this roasted pepper is going to taste like. So now it just came off. It's nice. It's really hot yet. I'm going to stick it in a Ziploc bag. I'm going to seal it because I want it to steam. You're going to see it's already starting to build steam right away. That steam is what's going to help allow that outer layer of skin to peel off real nice because we want to get rid of that and we want to keep just the flesh. So now it's been steaming. Take it out, and we're just going to start peeling away the skin. It comes right off, just like if you were blanching a tomato, kind of the same concept, except we're not shocking it in water right away. We're just going to let it steam. And you want to get all the, you don't have to get all the skin off, but you want to get a good portion of it off. And get rid of the stem and the seeds. Messy, but it's worth it. That's good. And if you got a little bit of that char left on there, that's okay. It kind of gives whatever this finished product's going to, it'll give the look of that nice, you know, charred, kind of rustic looking vinaigrette that we're going to end up having when we're done. And it also imparts some flavor. So for vinaigrette in this case, we are going to dice this very thin, very small. So it whisks into our vinaigrette nice and smooth. This is going to be a vinaigrette that's going to be what you'd be, what you would call a broken vinaigrette. It kind of has that look of where it's separated, like the oil and vinegar are kind of separated. And we want that in this case. Nothing too precise. Toss that into our mixing bowl. So we're going to start to assemble our vinaigrette here now. And we're going to throw some red onion in there. Also, very finely diced. Now for the fresh herb part. Can't put too many in there. Fresh is good. So we got some fresh thyme here. Let's peel away the stems. Keep the leaves. Just run it right between your fingers. Quick chop and some fresh parsley. This will add some sweetness and some aromatics and some really nice color too. And now for the actual vinaigrette portion of it. Vinaigrette is simple to make, very simple, a simple ratio to keep in mind, 3 parts oil to 1 part vinegar. That's a vinaigrette. Whatever you do after that point is just making it whatever flavor you're going to add, however interesting you want to make your vinaigrette. So I've got some olive oil here. And I've got rice vinegar. Rice vinegar you can find in the store. I like to use rice vinegar as opposed to white distilled vinegar. It's not as harsh. It's a little bit sweeter. Just has a much more pleasant flavor than the white distilled vinegar. And you could use that anytime you would use white distilled vinegar. I'm gonna crack some pepper in there. Freshly cracked, preferably. Some salt. And just a pinch of sugar. Just whisk that together till, it's all nice and incorporated. And this is something that would be great that you could serve over like a piece of grilled chicken or steak, pork. It'd be great with seafood, fish, shrimp. Really versatile. Really could go anywhere. You could serve it on grilled vegetables. And it's just a really... It looks really nice on the plate. It's a nice looking plate sauce. If you can imagine, if we had a maybe a steak or a nice piece of chicken, like I said, or a nice piece of salmon, the way this looks on the plate is just really nice. It's a garnish in and of itself. And it tastes great.